and John Derek Hobbs, Wexford Fire. Just before we start, I must point out to your fire exits. For the people downstairs, you have two fire exits. One at the front of the hall, one at the back of the hall, both on your right-hand side, and also the door in which you come in. For the people on the balcony, your fire exit is up at the back of the balcony, on your left-hand side, and also the door in which you come in. We'd like to give a very warm welcome to our adjudicator tonight. No stranger to Tops, definitely no stranger to us here in Wexford. Please welcome Mr. Michael Toomey. The interval tonight will take approximately 45 minutes. We'd ask you to please yak in your seats in 45 minutes. If you're leaving the theatre during the interval, please make sure you have to take your ticket with you to get back in again. Now, in case any of you are thinking about going to any of the national stages, if you look on the back of the programme, it'll give you all the details of where they are and also the booking form. So if you're thinking about going, please hold on to your programme. You'll need that to get your tickets. Without any further delay, the producer is Patricia Kelly. The show is called Here and Now. Please welcome on stage Coolcott's Variety Group.
Thank you.
with you. Hold you in my arms again. Stop you talking like a bloody hen. I just wanna dance with you. How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? Yes, they're all very, very welcome. I hope I didn't toss my hair during that dance floor. My mommy used to say to me, Daniel, you will go far. But mommy says, I never want to leave you. Then the other day I come home, and mommy was very, very cross. Daniel, she says, did you get a wee girl into trouble? Yes, mommy, says I told her daddy she smoked. But then today I got word from the Vatican that I could not believe.
Young Daniel of King Castle, I love you.
It was the Pope to say that I'm to be beatified, Ireland's first living saint. From now on you can call me Saint Daniel of King Castle. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please put your hands together for our first guest, all the way from Glenroe.
How are you there, Daniel?
How are you doing, Dinny?
Not too bad at all. Actually, Daisy gave me something to give to you. I'm going to throw these at you, but I'm not on sorry shoulder.
I'll try them on later, Dinny. How is Daisy?
But to tell you the truth, I think she's having an affair. She bought herself one of those new Wonder Bras.
Wonder Bras?
It's sort of a shape dog for bosoms. It sort of rounds them up and points them in the right direction.
Thank you very much, Dinny. Now, ladies and gentlemen, my next wee song comes from a new album. It's called The Smell of Me Mammy's Bacon and Cabbage Throws Me Home Across the Sea. And the wee number is a little song entitled The Little Green Underpants Me Mammy Knit For Me. It's a sad song. If you should ever start your knitting, oh, please knit one for me. I hope your wool balls aren't too tickly to cause discomfort, you see. An orange and green underpants for Daniel, now that it's already done. Oh, mommy, I'll never forget you. I hope I don't get a rash on my... I nearly said a bold word. Our next guest, ladies and gentlemen, at no expense in the Daniel O'Donnell Show, all the way from Memphis, Tennessee, Elvis Presley. Elvis said it's lovely to be here in Ireland in the land of saints and lotteries.
Yes, sir.
Well, how are things, Elvis?
And also not the bells. Oh, love you, man. Love you. Love you.
Did you meet Frank Bruno, Elvis?
No, I don't talk to that guy at all. No, where? Actually, I'm... You thought I was dead, didn't you?
Yeah.
No, I'm not dead, you know. I'm just taking a break. Thank you. Have a good day.
Yeah. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, without you, my fans, I would not be me. And without me, you would not be you. And you know something? Every year, 3,000 of you make a wee pilgrimage to my mommy's house in Kincastle. And I see Mary down there. And Mary, here's a wee carnation for you. Where are you, Mary? There you go. What did you do with the cup? Bring the cup back the next time. And ladies, will you stop throwing items of your underwear at me on stage? Bras and panties and girdles. I've tried them all on, and they don't fit. Our last guest, ladies and gentlemen, comes all the way from Hollywood, Sylvester Stallone. Rocky, how are you doing?
I love you. I love you, baby.
Did you meet Frank Bruno, Rocky?
That's right, I just met Frank. He was going feet, five, 4 feet. Feet, five, 4 feet. I said, Frank, what are you doing? Pregnancy for your next pantomime? He said, no. I just be talking to Chris Eubank, and he gave me his telephone number. 3 5 4 feet.
Thank you very much, Rocky. Now, ladies and gentlemen,
gentlemen. There you are, Mary. Try that on there for a second. Just before we go, I want you all to join your hands, clap them together, and do my latest song. It's called My Ding-a-Ling. Yes, must be playing with your own ding-a-ling.
Good night, Douglas!
Thank you. reason to fall.
Once before.
pussy, and if he shits me, you can smoke his room.
Maria, where have you been?
I got stuck on the far side of the Wexford Bridge. Some little fellow with a beard is trying to close it down. Oh, he's some sexy little beast. And lad, didn't this dirty big rat come running out of the drainage scheme and beat me right there? Right there on the neck. 6 foot 6 he was. So hurry up, sister's got the downside now waiting for me. Anyway, I'm not with your gang anymore. I'm leaving.
You can't leave.
I can't vote. I have a divine right.
And your left one's not too bad either.
I have become a spice girl.
A spice girl?
Okay, hon, I'll be baby spice and you can be all the spice.
Thank you.
Thank you. all over my premises. I believe it all started in a nut. It looks like a riddle from the Riddler. It says riddly, diddly, 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 riddly, diddly. And it sounds like the lyrics to a Christy Moore song. I believe it's all started back at the mayor's Christmas party. I met this beautiful girl. I said, would you kiss me underneath the mistletoe? She said, I wouldn't kiss you under an anesthetic.
Thank you.
thanks for being so patient. The Century Fort is never, we're not too far away from it. Fair play to the stage crew and everybody else involved. Now, after this show, we have about 10 minutes of a little delay, and then we will be presenting the individual awards, which were chosen by our adjudicator in the preliminary rounds, Sean Myler. They have absolutely nothing to do with tonight's performances whatsoever. So, without any further delay, the producer is John Hanrahan. The show is called This Must Be the Place. Please welcome on stage Ferns Community Variety.
material. The PGs have announced they are bringing out a record. Would you believe it will feature Nelly Horney singing her version of Only Our Rivers Run Free?
Oh, opposition. They are all pushing. Please, board this plane. Oh, God, I know he's Russian. If not, I lose my pension and my car.
Please, take his money back. I promise he won't get the sack. If he'll arrange a holiday.
Defined the fate of millions of Europeans between 1941 and 1945. The primary goal of Nazi Germany, apart from global domination, was the total extermination of all Jews in Europe. By late 1941, after the invasion of the Soviet Union, the overwhelming mass of European Jewry had been brought under the control of the German authorities. It was at this point in the war when, after the 1E conference on the 20th of January 1942, that Reinhard Heydrich made plans for what became known as the final solution. It was decided that all Jews were to be evacuated to concentration camps in Eastern Europe. Many would be killed outright. The killings were done by mobile death squads in camps such as Auschwitz and Treblinka. Of an estimated 8.3 million Jews in Europe in 1939, about 6 million were killed by 1945. Our story is about one such concentration camp, Dachau. It's the 29th of April, 1945, the day when terror, death, despair, and finally, hope entered into the lives of its inhabitants.
Because our teacher says it's history. And we wrote home now. Want to hear it?
We heard his swan song. I've done nothing wrong, except me extension to mention.
Encyclopedia.
Encyclopedia, where did he get it?
No, he had to walk to school like all the rest of the kids.